Masechet Chulin, page 45. We are at the top of the page. Since we're dealing with treifot, we're going to deal with different type of perforation, how you treated a member of membranes of the brain, how you treated a perforation of a skull, and more. So we start with the situation of hol chorim bakanim. They said that Amar Rav Yehuda Amar Rav Nikva Knafa Mitztarfim Leruba. Here we learn when it comes to treifot that if the windpipe, you know, one of the two simanim bema is the windpipe and the esophagus. So if the windpipe was perforated and you have those small tiny holes around it, that is a circumference, which means it's all over, like a sieve, the question is, can you combine them? So Rashi hold that it has to be individually, levad, the ran. Rabbeinu Nisim said that mashe benehem mitztarfim, that what's between them can be combined. So they treated the Gemara said mitztarfim leruba, those small holes within the windpipe that perforated are joined together to constitute a majority of the circumference, and therefore if the collective size is the majority of the circumference, so therefore the windpipe is considered cut. And that's basically the way they both, Rabbeinu Nisim, hold. You see more on that in Torat Chaim. The Shach said it's only if it's one line. The Sefer HaEshkol said even if it's not. Anyway, Mativ Rav Yirmiya. This is Tosefta in Aholot, chapter 2. Ubegul Golot said that when it's come to a skull of a corpse, so they said, Yesh banekev echad aroch. So they has a round hole, at least the size of a drill bit used for surgery. Afilu yesh banekavim harbe. Then if the skull does not impart ritual impurity in a tent. So here, the skull that contain one long hole, even if it has many small holes, the areas of the hole joined together to constitute the size of a drill hole. Mitztarfim l'mlo makdeach. So you derive from that, alma, kevan de shiura, because the requisite measure is the size of a drill hole, melo makdeach, so therefore the small hole joined together, limlo mekdeach mitztarfin. So those joined together to constitute the size of a drill hole and not another measure. Limlo mekdeach mitztarfin, hachana mekevan de shiurei keisar, lecheisar mitztarfin. So the same way here, since the requisite measure of a hole is to make the animal treifa is the size of isar, as we learn on page 54. The small hole should join together to constitute the size of an isar. So the question is, why do we have this requisite to have the majority of the circumference? So the Gemara said, Ishtemitetei Hade Amar. So Rav Yirmiya, it's escaped for him what Rav Rabbi Chelbo Amar, Rabbi Chama Bar Guri Amar Rav, Nekavim Sheyesh Bahem Chisaron, perforations that are deficiency, which is a hole of significant area, Mitztarfim Lecheisar, joined together to constitute the size of an Isar. If you have together the size of isar, that's make it treifa, v'she'en ben chisaron, and perforation that are not a deficiency but are small as the whole of the sieve, mitzarfim leruba, must join together to constitute a majority of the circumference, which is the measure of a cut windpipe. So since the holes are not substantial in area, the windpipe cannot be said to be missing a piece, but it may be considered cut. It's a diyun baposkim, it's a discussion among the most contemporary, if you do the same when it's come to off, to fall and birds. Another halakha in conjunction to this, Amar Rabba Bar Chana, Amar Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi, Nitla Heimena Retzua Mitztarefet Lecheisar. He said if a strip of the windpipe was removed from it, its area joins to constitute the size of an Isar, even if the strip itself is narrower than an Isar. Be'a mine Rabbi Yitzchak bar Nachmanin im Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi, nikva knafa mau, if the windpipe was perforated like a sieve, amar lei, Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi said, are amru, the sages said in regards to this, nekavim sheyesh bem chisaron, mitztarfin lecheisar, v'chshein bem chisaron, mitztarfin leruba. Perforations that are a deficiency joined together to constitute the size of an isar, and perforations that are not a deficiency joined together to constitute a majority of the circumference. So the Gemara raised a question. Based on that, the measure of an isar for missing flesh in a windpipe applies solely to animal. So in birds, it cannot be the measure, as the entire width of the windpipe is less than the diameter of an isar. So what's the measure of the bird? Be'of amai. Amar Rabbi Yitzchak bar Nachman im Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi nikva אמר רבי יהושע בן נחמן לדידי מפרשלי, אמר רבי יצחק בן נחמן לדידי מפרשלי מיני דרבי אליעזר, מקפלו מניחו על פי הקנה. So he said, fold and lay it over opening of the windpipe. אם חופה את רוב הקנה טריפה, ואם לאו כשירה, if it covers the majority of the windpipe, the animal is a טריפה, and if not, the animal is kosher. אמר רב פאפה וסימנך נפיה. Papa said, it's you, mnemonic, for this halakha should be a sieve. If the issue is perforated like a sieve, one must place it over the opening of the windpipe as if it were a sieve. So you see in Shulchan Aruch, in Rema, in the Taz, in the Shach, see also the Chazonish and the Reb Chaim Na'eh. Chazonish Reb Chaim Na'eh, there's a disputation when it's come to even the Shiurei Tabaot. There is a book called Midot V'Shiurei Torah. In that book, Midot V'Shiurei Torah, he brings the Darkei Teshuva, when and how you can depend on Arkaot Shelahem or not when it's come to Shiurei Matbeot. But anyway, Nifcheta Kedelet, if the windpipe was missing a piece so that it appears like a door, where the missing flesh was partially attached as though on a hinge. Amar Rav Nachman, kedei shikanes isar lechorbo. If the missing piece is so large that an isar can enter the hole widthwise, which is it's wider and taller than an isar, the animal is treifa. Nisdeka, but if the windpipe was cracked, although it's length, Amar Rav afilu nishtaer ba el chuliyah achat lemala vechuliyah achat lemata kshera. If the windpipe was cracked along its length, so even if only one undamaged segment remains in the windpipe above the crack and one segment below it, the animal is kosher. Amuah kamei de Rabbi Yochanan. So the sages said this statement before Rabbi Yochanan, who said, Amar ma chulia uma chulia de ka'amar Rav. So he said, what is the segment and what is the segment that Rav said? Segments are immaterial to the matter. אלא אם אפילו נשאר בה אלא משהו למעלה או משהו למטה כשרה. Even if any amount remain intact in the windpipe above the crack and any amount below, the animal is kosher. So here is Rashi. Rashi said, חוליית טבעת, שמעתי ובעיניי נראה שהם שלוש טבעות, כי דאמרים בנחות לפמטר, כדי שיקרוך וישנה וישלש, הווי חוליה לגבי ציצית. So that's Rashi versus the Shita Mekubetzet. Shita Mekubetzet said that Chulia, it's Tabad v'abasar liyada. Anyway. Amaru akamei d'Rabbi Yochan mishmei d'Rabbi Yonatan, achei amar lehu yad'in chavrin bavlai leperushei ki haitama. He says, the sages of Eretz Yisrael says before Rabbi Yochanan, name of Rabbi Yonatan of Babylonia, that any amount of undamaged tissue above and below the crack makes the animal kosher. So Rabbi Yonatan said to them, so our friends in Babylon know how to interpret according with this explanation. He was happy that Rabbi Yonatan interpreted in the same way he did. Now the Gemara goes to the borderline of the windpipe when it's come to Shechita. Tana Rabbi Yechia bar Yosef kamei de Rabbi Yochanan. Kol ha-tzavar kulo kasher l'shechita. The entire neck is fit for slaughter. Mitabat ha-gdola ad kanfei re'ah ha-tachtona. From the large uppermost ring of the windpipe downward until the lower edge of the lung. Amarav ha-tachtona shehi elyona. Rava said that the phrase lower edges of the lung is referring to an animal hung by the feet. That is, it actually denotes the upper edges near the head. Shani omer kol poshet et tzavara v'ro'a ubilvad shelo te'anes. So he said that the area feet for slaughter is all the length of the neck that an animal extends in order to graze, provided that it is not forced to extend its neck further than it wishes. So what you see is a result that the very bottom of the neck is not a location fit for slaughter. By Rav Chanina v'iteima Rav Chananya ansa atzma mahu. So if the animal forces itself and extends its neck, how you treated the additional area, what exactly the halakha? So the truth is a machloket between Rashi and Tosfot, what exactly occurred. But anyway, Gemara left it, teiku, stand unresolved, and the Rashi said, that sveika you go lechumra. So the shechita, it's a psula. So you have three different chilukei dinim when it's come to windpipe. Anyway, Yativ Rabbi Yochanan and Rabbi Shimon Lakish nafak milta benayu. So they both sat together, these brother-in-laws, and matter emerged between them. They said, Anas besimanim v'shachat psula. If the shochet forced the animal to extend the simanim by stretching the neck and slaughtered the animal at the lower end of the neck, the slaughter is not valid. Nikava kane lemata min hachaze nidon kerea. If the windpipe was perforated below the breast, it's considered to be like a perforated lung, which makes the animal treifa, no matter the size of the perforation. The perforation in the upper windpipe must be the size of an isar to make the animal treifa. That's what we study on page 54. Tanu Rabbanan ezeu chaze. As we know that the peace offering is lesser consecrated. The owner owns the meat, and anyone who's pure can eat it inside the wall of Yerushalayim. But some part of that, which is the breast, the chazesh or karamin, you give it to Kohanim, and only the Kohanim and his household can eat it based on the Torah in Vayikra chapter 7, Mishnah in Zvachim 55. So, ezehu chazeh, which is the breast that must giving to Kohanim as a gift from every peace offering. Leviticus chapter 7, verse 31. Ze haro'eh et hakarka, the section that faces the ground, not the ribbed area on the sides. And lengthwise, it extends below when the animal is hung from the legs. Lemata ad ha-tzavar, lemala ad ha-keres, until the neck, and above, until the ramen. וחותך שתי הצלעות משתי הדפנות, אילך ואילך, וזהו חזה הניתן לכהנים. And cuts the two ribs nearest the head from the two sides of the animal from both directions. And this is the breast that is given to the Kohanim. So Rashi said that it's שתי צלעות מהבהמה. Tosfot disagree. And you see in Tosfot, but there are those mefarshim that say that that's applied to tzlaot ktanot, small size. Small ribs. Now the third trifa that we mentioned in the Mishnah, nikav krum shel moach. If the membrane of the brain was perforated, so the animal is treifa. Rav Shmuel d'amri travayhu, karmai la'a afal gav delo inkiv tata'a. So the both, Rav and Shmuel said that the brain is covered by two membranes, a thick outer membrane that adjusts to the skull, and a thin inner membrane that connect to the brain. So the animal is trefied, the outer membrane was perforated. Ba'amrila, and some say that the animal is not trefied unless adin kivtata, unless the inner membrane was perforated as well. Amar Rabbi Shmuel bar Nachmani v'simanech. He says that the is eunemonic to remember this halacha is chayta demitnach beimocha, the bag in which the brain rests, which is the inner membrane. So the Kolbo in Ilchot Treifot, he wrote Chamesh Treifot Ish Barosh v'simanam. Bring a pasuk in Tehilim Ayin Chet, v'shikmontam b'chanamal. Bet kvuri krumim shebarosh shenikvu, chasera gulgolet kesela nechbesaro v'gulgolet mesus shenitmasmes amoach. So, the famous Mordechai brings the Tosfot in Gittin. There's a famous story about Titus, that he lives, some said 6, some said 7 years. It was a mosquito that when they opened the head, the skull, so it's the size of a small bird. So how come? So they said, there's a few explanations. Some said that you don't learn from Ma'aseh Nisim. Some said that Hashem wants to teach us that. Some said that he came to his nostrils. ולא עבר שני קרומים, it didn't pass through two קרומים. The Midrash ויקרא רבה פרק י' ג' said as follows, כמין גולגולת של אש הראה לו הקדוש ברוך הוא למשה מתחת כיסא הכבוד, the creator showed to Moses, how, ואמר לו אם ניקב קרום של מוח אפילו כלשהו טריפה. את יוסף said, קרום הדבוק למוח. Anyway, you can read more on that in my brother-in-law book. Daf al Daf, he expand on that a lot. Amar Rabba Bar Bar Chana, Amar Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi, Kenegdo Bebeitzim. Nikar. So he said, even though the inner membrane of the brain is very thin and not easily visible, it's equivalent to his testicle, which are also enclosed in a thin membrane. It's suspicious as it has an appearance different from the testicle themselves. Now, again, as we said, that the Shita Mekubetzet expand on that, but anyway, Amar Rabbi Shimon Pazi, Amar Rabbi Shua Ben Levi, Mishum Babar Kapara, Moach, Kol Ma Shebakdeira, brain, everything that inside the skull, Nidon Kemoach, is considered as part of the brain. So the treifa is nekev kol shehu, any size. Hitchil im shoch, from the point where it begins to extend like a cord out of the base of the skull, nidon kechut hashidra, it's considered the spinal cord. Umeichan matchil limashech, and from where does it begin to be extended? Amar Rabbi Yitzchak bar Nachmani ledidi miparsheli minei Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi, is himself that said kemin shnei, is this is like appear like similar to a two beans lie at the opening of the skull. 45b polin yesh munachim al pri agdera min apolin milifnim kelifnim min apolin velchutz kelchutz upolin atzma min yodea umistabra kelifnim. Here we talk about those beans that lie at the opening of the skull. Many of you have those pictures in the Gemarot. You see at the spinal cords, and according to obviously experts, scientists, people in the medicine, they tell you that polin, the beans, that's the chelak merkazi b'moach. They argue that it's a very crucial part of the brain. So from the bean inward, the nerve tissue is considered like the inside, which is the brain, and consequently, if its membrane is perforated, even minimally, the animal is treifa. From the beans outward, the nerve tissue is considered like the outside, the spinal cord, and a perforation of the membranes in this area renders the animal treifa only if the spinal cord is mostly out. And with the area that the bean themselves, he says, I do not know what halacha is. Reasoning mistabra, it stand to reason that it is considered like the inside, kilifnim. Rabbi Yirmiyah badak be'ofa. Rabbi Yirmiyah inspects a bird. Ve'ashkach kemin shnei polin munachin al pi agdera. He found a like similar to two beans lying at the opening of the skull. So it means not only in animals there are those beans, that you can find the borderline between the brain to the spinal cord, but also you can argue and say that's the Bet Yosef in Yoredei Ala Medalef, that it's also in a bird. The Ol Zarua, Taf Zayin, expand on the how you make these shiurim. For example, Chut HaShidra, the spinal, how you do the shiur berubo. It's a, both the book Tmunei Chol, Sichat Chulin, and Ol Zarua expand on that. Anyway, Nikav Halev Leveit Chalalo, if the heart was perforated to its chamber, the animal is treifa. Bai Rabbi Zera levet chalal katan or levet chalal gadol. So Rashi explains, the question is, You talk about small chamber within the heart or the large one. So Rashi explained that in the heart there are many chambers that have some of them like small one. That's the way Rashi said. Rashba in Torah Tabayit HaKatzar hold that there are three chambers, one large and two small in both sides, in the heart and in the left. The Pirush HaMishnayot in the Rambam and also the Rambam in L'chot Shechita chapter 6 applies to two chambers, one large on the left side and one small on the right side. But Sichat Chulin and Darkei Tshuva expand on that. So obviously, yes, you see there's at least two, you may say three views between Rashi, Rashba and the Rambam. Amar le'abaye le'rabi Zeira, Mighty Bayelach, what exactly your predicament, what is your safek, the quandary? Milot nan Rabbi Shimon omer ad she'tinakev leveit ha-simfonot. Rabbi Shimon said that it's not true fun unless it's perforated to the bronchi. So they said, Amar Rabba bar Tachlif, Amar Rabbi Irmiah bar Abba, Amar Rav ad she'tinakev le-simfon gadol, until it's, unless it's perforated through the large bronchus. If it happens, so therefore we presume that the Mishnah is referring to the large chamber of the heart as well. The Gemara rejected that and said, Hache Ashta, how can these cases be compared? Hatam Leveta Simfonot Ktani. Over there, the Mishnah teaches that the bronchi, which is the plural form, the one bronchus into which all the symphonot, all the bronchi empty out. But here, hadam levet ha-symphonot ketani le'echad ishafchi symphonot le'kulu, ve'acha le'beit chalalo ketani, ma'alich halal gadol, ma'alich halal ketan. Here we talk about the large chamber, and what's what is it to me if it's a small chamber? The language does not indicate one or the other. So as we said, the Rashi hold that there are bechadarim ktanim, that there are many small chamber. As we said, the Rambam, the Pachad Yitzchak, and many doctors, you know, challenge that. I remember studying it with my Chavrusa, who is a veterinarian, Rav Aaron Weisberg. I have an animal hospital. He is a veterinarian close to 3 decades. And he's the one of the advisor to Star K in Baltimore, and a very important component of the Rabbi Heinemann Shlita team. So he also challenged this Rashi here. Anyway, Knei Alev, Aorta, Rav Amar Mashu, Shmuel Amar Berubo. That's the chief artery existing in the heart. Rav says, like the heart itself, if it's perforated in any amount, the animal is a trefa. Shmuel said the animal is trefa only if the aorta is perforated in its majority. Heini ukne alev. So which blood vessel is the aorta? Amar Rabba bar Yitzchak, Amar Rav chelev she'al gabei dfanot. So Rabba bar Yitzchak said that this is the artery found in the fat of the sides. So the Rashi, you see it in other commentaries, that when you use chelev, usually it's applied to fat, that prohibited for consumption. But when the Torah used the term chelev, regardless if it's a pure or impure, that's used chelev versus shuman. That's the differentiation between chelev mutar, chelev asur, as we learned earlier on page 43. שתי חתיכות, אחת של שומן, אחת של חלב. So therefore, we understand why they use the term שומן also. But the Ramban in Vayikra, chapter 3, verse 9, expand on that. So the Gemara said, דפנות צל כדעתך. So they אלא שעל גבי דופני הריאה. So this referring to the artery covered in the fat that exists in the heart passes to the side of the lung. אמר המאמר משמי דרב נחמן, תלתה קטנהו. We have here three ducts that adjacent to the one another in the animal's chest. And here we expand on that. חד פריש לליבה, חד וחד פריש לריאה, וחד פריד לחבדה. So one separates to the heart, one separates to the lung, and one separates to the liver. וחד פריש לחבדה, so that's the liver, דריאה כריאה, דחבדה כחבדה, דליבה פליגי. So he said the duct of the lung, treated like the lung, make the animal trephies perforated in any amount, the duct of the liver, treat like the liver, and only if it's completely missing, that it make the animal trepha, that's follow the Mishnah, and the duct of the heart, you have a disputation between Rav and Shmuel, the liba pligei, if na'asa trepha benekev, mashu o beribo, the measure of its perforation, as we mentioned earlier. Mar bar chia matnei ipcha, just the reverse, and he said dereah kechavda, the duct of the lung treated like the liver, and make the animal trepha only if it's completely missing. Dechavda kereah, the duct of the liver treated like a lung, and perforation of any amount renders the animal trepha. The liba pligei, in the heart, that's the disputation between Rav and Shmuel. As the Rav trifa benekev mashehu, Shmuel, until the majority, עד שיפסק רובו. עזר רבי חייא בר יוסף, אמרה לשמעתי דקרב כמה ידי שמואל, אמר לי, יחי אמר רבא, לא ידע בטריפות ולא כלום. If he said that, Rav, so he doesn't know much about הלכות טריפות. Use strong term, לא ידע ולא כלום. Anyway, נשברה הגדרה ונפסק החוט שלה. The Mishnah states, if the spinal column was broken and its cord was cut, the animal is treifa. תנו רבנן, חוט השדרה שנפסק ברובו. The spinal cord was cut in its majority. So obviously, the animal is treifa, דברי רבי. רבי יעקב אומר, אפילו ניקב. He says, even, ביעקב says, it is treifa, even the spinal cord was only perforated. הורה רבי כרבי יעקב. Even he hold that the spinal is not treifa until she pasek rubo, the majority, he did not depend on his own statement, but he was more machmir, his stringent, as Rabbi Yaakov hold, and even nekev b'mashu, even a small perforation, he prohibited it. So the Gemara put the final halakha and said, Amar Ravuna ein halakha k'Rabbi Yaakov. So the halakha is not k'Rabbi Yaakov, so, and basically only the Rebbe, that only if the majority of the spinals was cut, then only then is treifa. Even Rebbe was more stringent upon himself and followed the view of Rabbi Yaakov, the halakha follow Rebbe. Which means you can be stringent to yourself, but in some halakha, in this sense, they are more lenient. V'cham arubo rav amar rov oro, v'amre la rov mocho. Rav said the majority of the circumference of its surrounding membranes, the meninges, and some said the majority of the nerve tissue of the spinal cord itself. So even if the meninges are intact, the animal is a treifa if the majority of the nerve tissue is cut. Manda marov mocho kol sheken rov oro. The one who says the majority of the nerve tissue is severed, all the more so if the majority of the meninges is cut. Since the meninges, the protective membranes are damaged, the nerve tissue itself will certainly be damaged soon thereafter. But according to the one who says that tear in the majority of the meaning makes it treifa, what's the halakha in the case where the majority of the nerve tissue was cut? So you can say that the intact remembrances will keep the damage from spreading. There is a Tosfot here. He In short, he hold again that that's the rov, nifsak rubo, tashma, the amar nivlei amar avuna. Rubo shamru rov oro. When the sages said, says the majority of the spinal cord, which they said make the animal to a five cut, is rov oro. The majority of the meninges, but this nerve tissue makes no difference. Mo'achzeh lo ma'aleh ve'lo morid. There is a book called Tmunei Chol that have a different explanation. Anyway, Rav Natan Baravin havayativ kamei derav badak berov oro ve'kabadik berov mocho. Amar leim rov oro kayam mo'achzeh lo ma'aleh ve'lo morid. So he said it's the if the majority of the meanings is intact, the nerve tissue makes no difference. Now the Gemara dealing with a spinal cord, different issues. Marabba Barchana Marabbi Yusha Belevi Nitmarech Pasul. So he said that if the spinal cord was liquefied, the animal is unfit for consumption. Nitmasmes Pasul. Even if the softened, the animal is unfit, streifa. Ezoi amracha vezoi hamas masa, which is liquefaction and which is softening. Liquefaction is in any case in which the nerve tissue become liquid, and if the membrane is punctured, it can be poured out like water from a jug. Amracha kol nishpach kekiton. Masmasa kol she'enu yachol la'amod. Softening in any case in which the nerve tissue cannot stand upright on its own, and the sages when it's not been supported. Bai Rabbi Yirmiya, enu yachol la'amod mifnei kovdo. Mahu. If they were in the spinal cord became unusually heavy, such as it cannot stand upright due to its weight, but not due to the softening or melting, what's the halacha? Osed teiku, unresolved. And we learned that Rashi said, any suffix that is left in teiku, you go home, you go stringent. Tmunei chol again, have a different understanding. Be Rav Amre nit masmez pasul, nit mazmez kasher. So they, Bei Rav, they hold that if it was softened, it's unfit, but if it was empty from the spinal cord, the animal is kosher. Meitivei, Rabbi Shimon ben Elazar omer bema shenitmazmez mochat reifa. So the Gemara raises the objection based on the Braita. Rabbi Shimon ben Elazar said, an animal whose nerve tissue was empty from the spinal cord is treifa. So that's challenged what the students of Rav said, that is nitmazmez amoach, the spinal cord, it's not treifa. So according to the Rabbeinu Asher in Siman Yud Bet, so it's not the moach of chut hashidra, the spinal cord, but moach bagulgolet, the one, the brain in the skull. And the Rosh hold that therefore the same dinim, the moach of Rosh chut hashidra is the same as moach of the skull. Ha'hil itmasmes itmar. That version of the writer is incorrect. In fact, the word softening was stated, not the word emptied. So the Gemara asks, Eini, is that so that the animal whose nerve tissue has dissolved is kosher? V'hal Levi hava yativ bei masuta. Levi was sitting in the bathhouse. Chazi alu gavra detari l'reishe. He noticed a person who banged his head severely in the wall. Amar nit mazmez mochin dedei. So he said, this man nerve tissue was softened and been empty. Lav de lo chaye. So it means it's not Levi meant that the man cannot live. If so, the softening and emptying of the nerve tissue should make the animal a treifa. So Amar Abaye lo, Abaye said no. He intended to say that lomar she'ino molid, that the man cannot reproduce, since head trauma must lead to situation that he would not be able, infertility, he will not be able to bring future generations. So you see that here is the koach ha'olada ba me'amoach, and in a way it's not like what we said earlier, that the argument is that you cannot compare person to animal. Here you see that there is some comparison. So the Chacham Tzvi and others ask a question about the animal that was brought for a shaila, for a question. In those days they used to have melicha levad, putting the soul independently. So that person come and ask, she didn't find the heart. So the question is, they said, if nikav lev treifa, if you see a perforation of the heart, it makes the animal treifa, so kal vachomer nitar. So he tried to answer that maybe a cat took that. But the Chazon Ish said, if you argue and you say that there is another part of the body that can do the job of the heart, so therefore why you call it treifa? But if you zoom in the Chacham Tzvi in Siman Ayin Zayin 77, he brings the Zohar. He says that lo yitachen leben adam lichyot rega echad belo lev. Person cannot live even a second without heart. Now, if you read the Tosfot on 42b, Yivor Atchil Ve'amar, de lo yalfin an treifot ba'adam be'ma me'adam. How you compare? But anyway, Chacham Tzvi disputed. You see it. He said that lo shayach klal shebema tichir rega bli lev, it's impossible for animal to live 1 second without the heart. And he said it's impossible. Tosfot said the opposite, person is mazel and otherwise not. But anyway, as we said, that the argument of the Chazon Ish makes a lot of sense, because when he said, if you argue and you say that it was able to function without lev, without the heart, so why you call it a streifa? And again, those who have time, please see it both in Tosfot and Shu'ut Chacham Tzvi, Siman Ayin Zayin.